Snappy is a universal packaging format with sandboxing capabilities, originally designed for Ubuntu Phone and Internet of Things or IoT devices. The packages are called Snaps, and the installer is called Snapd or Snapdemon. One of the problems in Linux is too much variety. There are too many distributions, desktops, and package managers. From a developer point of view, it makes Linux a less appealing system to release software for, in comparison to Windows, Mac OS, and Android, which offer a far shorter list of packaging formats. Ubuntu have attempted to combat the fragmentation side of package management with a universal packaging format called Snaps. Snaps can be packaged and installed in any Linux distribution which has Snapd daemon installed. In the future, it may be possible to install Snap packages in macOS and Windows. All dependencies can be included within the Snap, which on the negative side does require additional disk space, but on the positive side means you are not limited to having software that was built at a specific time for a fixed release operating system. I will admit there is not much benefit for users of rolling release distributions like Arch, Gentoo or OpenSUSE Tumbleweed, but not everyone wants to be on the bleeding edge. For IoT devices or business critical systems, it may be completely impractical to have a rolling release system. Personal package archives or PPAs can be added to Ubuntu or Debian to provide newer applications to the older OS. However, conflicts may arise with shared libraries. When conflicts occur, it is down to the user to resolve the problem. Snaps can be updated up to 4 times a day by default or as specified by the user. Automatic health checks can be implemented to verify that the update has been successful, and it can automatically roll back to an earlier version should an update fail. Updates are incremental, meaning that the overall size will be smaller than the original install. Only the 3 most recent updates of a snap are kept. Snaps can be installed from different development stages. By default, there are 4: Stable, Candidate, Beta, Edge. Stable is what most users will consume, and as the name suggests, should be the most polished, stable, and tested version of the app. Candidate is used to vet uploads that should require no further code changes before moving to stable. Beta is used to provide preview releases of tested changes. Edge is used for most recent changes, probably untested, and with no guarantees attached. Snaps are containerized using SquashFS, a read-only file system which gets mounted as a loop device upon system boot up. There are 3 levels of confinement for the snap: strict, classic, and dev mode. Strict is the default security policy applied to snaps. The snap has read-write writes only in its own install space and selected areas. It has access to any libraries it bundles, as well as the core snap. It can also access certain requested hardware interfaces. For example, a webcam viewer would request access to an attached camera. This connection would be strictly controlled via the core snap. A snap in classic confinement behaves as a traditionally packaged application with full access to the system. Snaps using this fully open security policy are manually reviewed in the snap store. Dev mode or developer mode has the same policies as strict. However, these security denials are turned into warnings. Snaps using dev mode cannot be released into stable and candidate store channels. There are 3 main commands for using Snappy: snap find, snap install, and snap remove. Once installed, an application can be accessed as though it was traditionally packaged, either via the terminal or desktop application searcher. The easiest way of finding snaps is with the unofficial website UApp Explorer. The main benefits of snaps for users are: easily add newer software without worrying about conflicts, sandboxing capabilities and restricting the app's ability to see your entire operating system. The main benefits of snaps for developer are: easiest package applications for Linux, and supply updates to users much quicker. Thanks for watching, I'll see you all later.